Hello and welcome friends. Welcome to this video on classification of proteins. Proteins are classified by several ways. First, based on their function. Second, based on their molecular shape. Based on their composition. And based on their nutritional quality. Let us see them one by one. First, classification of proteins based on the functions. First, catalytic proteins or enzymes. Catalytic proteins, called the enzymes, accelerate thousands of biochemical reactions. Example, glucokinase, dehydrogenases, transaminases, etc. Transport proteins. These proteins help in transportation of biomolecules. Example, hemoglobin binds and carries oxygen. Transferrin transports iron. Ceruloplasmin transports copper. Storage proteins. Many proteins serve as storage form of essential components. Myoglobin stores oxygen in muscles. Ovalbumin in eggs. Contractile proteins. Some proteins have the ability to contract and function in the contraction system of skeletal muscles. Example, actin and myosin. Structural proteins. Many proteins serve as supporting filaments or sheets to give biological structure, strength, and protection. Example, collagen, a fibrous protein of tendon. Elastin, keratin. Defense or protective proteins. Many proteins defend against invasion of foreign substances. Example, immunoglobulins or antibodies. Interferons, blood clotting proteins, etc. Regulatory proteins or hormones. Some proteins regulate cellular or physiological activities. Example, cellular receptors, hormone receptors. Protein hormones, example, insulin. Growth factors, example, platelet-derived growth factor. Genetic proteins. Some proteins are associated with genetic material and may help in their structure stability, compact packaging, etc. Example, histones. Stress response proteins. A capacity of living organisms to survive a variety of abiotic stress is mediated by certain proteins. Example, cytochrome P450, metallothionein, and heat shock proteins. Now, the second way of classifying proteins is based on their molecular shape. First, fibrous proteins. They are also called as scleroproteins. These proteins have minimum solubility. They have high molecular weight, fibers that are long and thin. Example, collagen, elastin, and keratin. Globular proteins. They are also called as spheroproteins on account of their spherical or ovoid shape. These are soluble proteins of relatively low molecular weight. Example, albumins, globulins, prolamines, protamines, etc. Now, the third way of classifying protein that is based on their composition and solubility. Based on this criteria, proteins are classified into three types: simple, compound or conjugated, and derived. Let us see simple proteins first. These protein contains only amino acid residues and no other chemical constituents. Example, albumins that are soluble in water and they are heat coagulable. Example, egg albumin, lactalbumin, etc. Globulins, they are insoluble in water and soluble in dilute neutral salt solution and are coagulated by heat. Example, serum globulins, ovoglobulins of egg yolk, etc. Glutelins. Glutelins are soluble in dilute acids and alkalis but are insoluble in neutral solutions. Example, glutelin of wheat, oryzanin of rice. Prolamines are soluble in 70 to 80% alcohol but are insoluble in water, neutral solvents or absolute alcohol. Prolamines are rich in proline but are deficient in lysine. Example, zein of corn and gliadin of wheat. Histones. Histones are soluble in water but are not coagulated by heat. Histones are basic proteins as they are rich in basic amino acids. Example, histones of DNA and RNA. Protamines. They are strongly basic and rich in basic amino acid arginine. The protamines are soluble in water but are not coagulated by heat. Like histones, they occur in tissues with nucleic acids. Scleroproteins, also called as albuminoid, are insoluble in water, dilute solutions of salts, acids, and bases. All scleroproteins have fibrous structures, hence sclero. In natural state, scleroproteins except elastin are not hydrolyzed by proteolytic enzymes and therefore have no nutritive value. Example, collagen, keratin, fibroin, etc. Now next is conjugated proteins. These proteins contain amino acid residues and other chemical constituents. The non-amino part of conjugated protein is referred to as the prosthetic group or the additional group. That means these proteins will have two components, two parts, the protein part and the non-protein part, that is known as the prosthetic group. And these proteins are further subdivided and subclassified based on the prosthetic group present. Glycoproteins. The prosthetic group is carbohydrates. Example, mucin of saliva, hormones like TSH, FSH, etc. Nucleoproteins. The prosthetic group is nucleic acid. Example, histones and protamines. Phosphoproteins. The prosthetic group is a phosphate. Example, casein of milk, vitelin of egg yolk, etc. Lipoproteins. These proteins, lipoproteins, are formed by a combination of proteins with prosthetic group lipid. These are molecular assemblies of lipids and proteins. Example, chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, and HDL. Chromoproteins. As the name suggests, chrome is colored. The prosthetic group is colored. Example, heme proteins that have prosthetic group heme includes hemoglobin, cytochromes, etc. Flavoproteins that have flavin nucleotides. Example, enzyme succinate dehydrogenase. Metalloproteins. The prosthetic group is metallic elements such as iron, zinc, calcium, copper, molybdenum, etc. Examples: ferritin has iron, calmodulin has calcium, dinitrogenase, molybdenum containing, carbonic anhydrase, zinc containing, and ceruloplasmin, copper containing proteins. Lectins. Lectins are precipitated by 30 to 60% ammonium sulfate. They are proteins having high affinity to sugar group. Example, a lectin from Phacelus vulgaris, that is red kidney beans, agglutinates all RBCs and WBCs. Another example, concavalin A from legumes will specifically attach glucose and mannose. Now, third type, the derived protein. These proteins are derived or obtained from simple and conjugated proteins, hence the name derived. The derived proteins are subdivided into primary derived and secondary derived proteins. First, we'll see primary derived proteins or denatured proteins. These protein derivatives are formed by agents such as heat, acids, alkalis, etc., which cause only slight change in the protein molecule and its properties without hydrolyzing cleavage of peptide bond or without hydrolyzing the peptide bond. They include proteins. These are the earliest product of protein hydrolysis by the action of dilute acids or enzymes. Example, myosin from myosin, fibrin from fibrinogen. Metaproteins. The metaproteins are formed by further action of acids and alkalis on proteins. Example, acids and alkali albuminates. Secondary derived proteins. These substances are formed in the progressive hydrolytic cleavage of the peptide bonds of metaproteins, that means the previous coagulated proteins, into progressive smaller molecules like proteases, peptones, and peptides. So friends, now let us move to the fourth type of classification, that is based on the nutritional value. First in this series is complete or first class proteins. These proteins are nutritionally rich. They contain all the essential amino acids in the required proportion. On supplying these proteins in the diet, children will grow satisfactorily. Example, egg protein, milk protein, casein, etc. Incomplete proteins. These proteins lack one essential amino acid. They cannot promote body growth in children, but may be able to sustain the body weight in adults. Example, proteins from pulses are deficient in methionine, and proteins from cereals are deficient in lysine. Poor proteins. These proteins lack in one or more essential amino acid. And a diet based on these proteins will not even sustain the original body weight. Example, zinc from corn lacks tryptophan and lysine. So friends, let us quickly summarize the classification of proteins. Proteins are classified based on their functions, molecular shape, composition, and nutritional quality. Based on their function, they are subdivided as catalytic proteins, transport proteins, storage proteins, contractile proteins, structural proteins, defense proteins, regulatory proteins, genetic proteins, and stress response proteins. Based on the molecular shape, they are subdivided into fibrous and globular proteins. Based on the composition, into simple, compound or conjugated, and derived. The details we'll see in the next slide. Nutritionally, they are classified into complete proteins, partially complete proteins, and incomplete proteins. Now, the classification of proteins based on the composition. They are subdivided into simple, conjugated and compound, and derived. Simple proteins are further subdivided based on their shape and solubilities, globular proteins and scleroproteins. Examples of globular protein includes albumin, globulins, prolamines, histones, etc. Scleroproteins examples are collagen, elastin, keratin. Conjugated proteins or compound protein based on the prosthetic group are subdivided as glycoproteins, nucleoproteins, phosphoproteins, lipoproteins, chromoproteins, metalloproteins, and lectins. Derived proteins are subdivided into primary derived, the coagulated proteins, or denatured proteins, and secondary derived, the hydrolytic proteins, hydrolytic products. Primary derived include proteins and metaproteins, and secondary derived include proteases, peptones, and peptides. Let's see a very simple mnemonic to remember this big classification. Zoom. Fastest moving car, NATO. Fastest, F. Classification of protein based on the functions. Moving, M. Classification of protein based on the molecular shape. Car, C. Classification based on the composition into simple, compound, and derived. And NATO, N. That is based on the nutritional quality. So classification of proteins based on function, molecular shape, composition, nutritional quality. Fastest, moving, car, NATO. I am thankful to all these resources for making this video possible. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching this video. Be happy, healthy, and stay safe. Thank you so much.